MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Minnesota Twins and the Chicago White Sox. The White Sox look for the series sweep at home against their division rivals. First pitch is next. Number 34 gets the ball in game three of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, you can only win your first big league game once, and in his last start, he did just that. I'm sure that ball is put away someplace very special. Nothing more he'd like to do than get win number two here in this one.
At the plate, Luis Arraez. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. Now the 1-1 pitch. Up the middle and in for a base hit.
Got a nice piece of hitting right there. When you're facing a young blood on the mound, young starting pitcher, you want to get him into the stretch as quick as possible. You want to see how he handles the moment, see if maybe you can run on him. A lot of things going to open up with this next at bat.
So now to the plate, Andrelton Simmons. Liner toward right center, and that's in there, base hit. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
Hey, they're seeing this pitcher well right now. They were obviously paying attention in the hitters meeting. He's found a barrel to the first two guys to start this game. Now he's got to worry about the middle of the order.
Into the box now, Nelson Cruz. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Fellas, these White Sox, as they enter play today, 4-2 over their last six games, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Roll, we're looking at a team that's playing some pretty good baseball right now. Through the first five games of this homestand, 4-1 and looking for some bigger and better things.
Yeah, we had a chance to sit down before the game after BP with the manager. He was really pleased with the way his team has played in these last five. Let's see if it continues today.
Runners at the corners here, nobody out. Push to the right side. And there's a base hit as the runner will score from third, and the Twins are on the board first, 1-0.
Hey, you tip your hat to the batter for finding a way to find some green grass out there, but man, that has to frustrate you, Dan. An executed pitch right there.
It does. Anytime you make a good pitch, and off the bat, it certainly didn't look like it was going to fall in for a base hit. You make a good pitch, but you don't necessarily always get the kind of results you want as a pitcher.
Standing in now, Miguel Sano. A two-ball, one-strike count to the Twins' first baseman. The 2-1 home.
It's not easy to continue pounding the strike zone when you've given up three consecutive hits, but he has to trust that getting the ball down in the zone will get him an out.
Simmons over at second. Cruz on at first with nobody out. Now a swing and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule. Up next for Minnesota, Mitch Garver. And now the Twins look to plate more in the opening frame. Gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Garcia is under it. Two gone. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. It was an 0-for-4 day for him in yesterday's loss. Two men are on with two men out. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. And there are the umpires assigned to this one. Balls and strikes belong to Mr. Jerry Hillsdale.
You know, D-Row, I think Jerry Hillsdale is a very good hitter's umpire. Doesn't give much on the edges. He's going to make you put the ball into the plate.
Oh, I love me some Jerry Hillsdale. You have to come over to...
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Twins forced to settle for one. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. The Twins are in front, 1-0. Jose Berríos gets the ball for the Twins in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy comes into this start, Matt, having lost two of his last three starts, so you know he wants to get off on the right foot in this one. One of the keys, getting outs early and establishing his off-speed pitch repertoire early on in this one. We'll see if he can do that in this one here today.
Striding into the box, Tim Anderson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And it's two balls and a strike for Tim Anderson. Fellas, these Twins, as they take the field this afternoon, despite the loss last time out, they enter this one in good shape, winners in seven of their last 10.
Yeah, Matty, this team has been playing really well right now, and this is case in point. Chance to jump out again to another 1-0 lead. They've really been doing that. They've been on attack, early offensive, almost ambush-like approaches to their at-bats, and it's working for them.
The 3-1. Fastball too high, ball four.
And don't forget, he lost his last time out, so he wants to get off on the right foot here. The last thing he wanted was to walk the leadoff man.
Adam Eaton digging in next. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Pulled toward right center field. Arise. Ranging into the outfield. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Oh, now here's a drive out to the alley. Anderson rounds third and is digging for the plate. He will score, and the White Sox have tied it. We're all square and one apiece.
That is what every manager is looking for out of the middle of his lineup. When you get your 3, 4, and 5 hitters producing this early in the season, it can be contagious, and everyone in the lineup starts to contribute.
At the plate, Eloy Jimenez. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Edwin Encarnacion waits on deck. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Center fielder on the run, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Digging in, Edwin Encarnacion. And the White Sox looking for more here in the game's opening frame. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Hit in the air down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Ready with the payoff pitch. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks in bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Jose Abreu. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Two men are on with two men out. All even now, 2-2. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Left fielder looking up, still going back. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. So a three-run blast to straightaway left. Home run number three here in the early going. And the White Sox will move out in front 4-1.
Wow, talk about a guy getting hot, right? Hits a bomb, hit one yesterday. Usually when he gets hot, he starts to hit them in bunches. And this could be the beginning of a very, very good hot streak.
Into the box, Yasmani Grandal. 1-2 to the White Sox catcher. Four runs here in this half inning. A bouncer to the left side. A diving try, but it's through into the outfield.
Boy, talk about a rough start to an inning. A three-run bomb and then a base hit. This could get real ugly, Hero.
Yeah, you can tell, Dan. He's going to have to execute a little bit better than that. They were sitting in that hitter's meeting, and they were ready. They're keeping their front shoulders in, looking for something up, out, over, and they are not missing it.
In now, Luis Robert. The 2-2. Doesn't get the call, and it's full now, 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that's through for a hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
At the plate now, Leury Garcia. Count still full, 3-2. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
So digging in now, Tim Anderson. Another first inning RBI opportunity for him here. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. Second inning coming up. It's now 4-1 Chicago. Second inning set to go, and next the dangerous power threat, Josh Donaldson. Ready to deal, here's the 1-1. Grounded back up the middle. Scooped up. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Stepping up to the plate, number 13. He'll take his first hacks here. Here's the 1-1. This is line to left. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
There's no question he's been struggling at the dish lately, trying to do anything to get himself going. So he's got to feel pretty good after that double. Not to take anything away from him, but I think I could have probably hit that pitch.
Yeah, that's one of those gift pitches, not the location he was shooting for. So now to the plate, Byron Buxton. There's a changeup taken, but it finds the zone on the inside. Well, as we mentioned at the top of the broadcast, the Shy Sox have their sights set on a series sweep here today.
This team going for the sweep is looking for some home cooking. It's always nice to win a series, but particularly nice when you can sweep a series at home.
Inside and a hair low, it's two balls and two strikes. The Pale Hose, however, have to beat their opposition's best as they've got to go up against their ace in this one.
This one isn't in the books yet, but when you're going for the sweep and you have a nice lead like they do early on here, things are looking awfully good for the sweep department.
So stepping in, Luis Arraez. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit, and the side is retired. Twins wind up stranding one. They trail it 4-1. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Adam Eaton. All even at 2-2, here it is. Here's Donaldson down at third. And there's one away. So here's Yoan Moncada. The 1-1.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire, so it's ball four.
Oh, man, that check swing was about as close as they get. Tough call for the umpire, but it goes the batter's way this time, and he draws the walk.
So a runner on first with one out now, and up next, the exciting Eloy Jimenez. The 2-1 home. A bouncer up the middle. Fielded cleanly. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Nothing doing here for the White Sox as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Top of the third set to get underway. And stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Andrelton Simmons. Now the 1-1 pitch. Nope. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. Following next is Nelson Cruz. He waits on deck. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. High and deep to right center. Center fielder giving chase. He's there and records the first out. So with one away, let's give you a look at the standings in the American League's Central Division as you see where these two teams find themselves entering our ballgame here today. Ready now, Nelson Cruz. He reached on a single in his first try. 4-1's our score here in inning number three. Chased a bad ball up out of the zone, 2-2.
He is in complete command out on the mound today. He's got all four corners locked in, and now he's raising eye levels to boot.
Miguel Sano is on deck. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Oh, and he lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four.
Well, he battled to get it to a 3-2 count, but that pitch wasn't even close. Now he's got a man on with one out, so he's got to focus on trying to get the ground ball.
Now the number four Minnesota hitter, Miguel Sano. He popped out in his first trip. Runners on first with one down. On its tailor made to short, 6-4-3. It's a double play and the inning is over. Twins retired in short order, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the power bat of Edwin Encarnacion. Now the 2-1. Waves and misses for strike number two.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
2-2 pitch is a fastball high, so it runs full, 3-2. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Fouled away. Fouled off. The 3-2 one more time. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Shows some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
So striding in, Jose Abreu. He hit a big three-run bomb in his first plate appearance.
The last at bat, Matty V, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches. Made him look silly with that one.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Chopped to third. Tough to get two. To second for one. On to first, and it's another double play. Already two of them here in the first three innings so far.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the two ball.
So base is empty now after the double play, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Yosmani Grandal. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. Pulled toward right center field. Buxton will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Good guys held in check here, but they lead it 4-1. All set for the start of the fourth, and next to hit is the catcher, Mitch Garver. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Usually you see chases outside the zone on off-speed stuff like sliders, breaking balls, and changeups. But to chase a fastball that far outside the zone tells me this hitter's not seeing it well at all.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. The 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Standing in now, Max Kepler. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Base hit into right center.
There's a lot of moving parts in some guys' swings. It usually takes them a month or so to get it ironed out.
To the plate now, Josh Donaldson. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine anything comes over the heart of the plate.
4-1 our score as we play inning number 4. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball 4.
He almost got him to commit there. As we take another look at it in slow motion, he comes awfully close to breaking that plane, but he was able to hold back. Strong wrist, and he gets a trip to first because of it.
Stepping in, number 13. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Eaton on the move. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Byron Buxton. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Skied into straightaway right. Eaton is under it. And that ends the inning. Twins strand a pair. They trail it 4-1. Now in the box, Luis Robert is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. 4 runs through 3 innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
Here now the 2-2. It is laid off and the count runs full.
It's been a great job so far by the 8-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Fly ball into straightaway left. Number 13 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Stepping in, Leury Garcia. In 8 at-bats in the series, he's collected 3 hits. The 2-1. Hit down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Here it comes. One out, nobody on. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. Stepping in now, Tim Anderson. 2-1 count to the Pale Hose leadoff hitter. hits this one hard the other way, right to him. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Down in order go the White Sox as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Luis Arraez. And he lays off again, ball three.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Hard hit ball to second. He's got it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. In now is Andrelton Simmons. Popped him up. Garcia ranging into shallow right. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Ready for another shot now. Nelson Cruz. It was a walk in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch is taken for strike two. One run, five hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Ripped down the first baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now here's the pitch. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Down go the Twins in order, and this is still a 4-1 ballgame. Standing in, Adam Eaton, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. A little too tall that time, 3-1 now.
Well, ball three here. Hey, and the White Sox would love to start it in and get that leadoff guy on. They'd love to get a leadoff walk right here.
Base hit, line drive into the corner. And now it'll rattle up against the wall. And the White Sox get something going here. It's a leadoff double.
You'd think they'd stop pitching to this guy by now. He's been torching them all weekend, and he stays hot here with another extra base hit. They'll be happy when this series is over so they don't have to deal with this dude anymore.
Here's the Minnesota skipper making his way out to the mound, and he's going to make a move as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart after working just 4-plus innings, as this will not go down as a quality start, that's for sure. Randy Dobnik is into the ballgame now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here. Into the box now, Yoan Moncada. 3-2 now. Eloy Jimenez is on deck. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. This one up, but this will land untouched. Payoff pitch one more time, and he misses ball four, so he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Standing in, Eloy Jimenez, 0-2 from him so far in this one. Here's the 2-1 to 2-2 now.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
From the belt, the pitch. Line drive to left. Number 13 is there, and he has it for the out. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Now at the plate, Edwin Encarnacion. It was a walk in his last trip. The 1-1 home. On the ground to second base, this could be two. To second for one, relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. White Sox leave one, but they lead it 4-1. Cody Hoyer takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Miguel Sano. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. And this one is over, and he works the count back to 2-2.
This offense has been underachieving all day, putting way too much pressure on their own pitching staff. Someone has to have a quality AB and get this line going.
This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Eaton is there, and he'll bring this one in. Striding in, Mitch Garver. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
It's all a part of learning how to pitch in the big leagues. Major league hitters will not bail you out by swinging at pitches out of the zone. So he's going to have to continue to learn how to get guys out at this level.
Digging in and looking for more, Max Kepler. He was a strikeout victim his first trip and then collected a base hit his last time around. That nibbled the corner there but missed, 2-1.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
You got him to go down after that one, and it's 2-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Jimenez is in pursuit. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. The next twin up, Josh Donaldson. Hits are even right now at five aside. Smoke toward the hole. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. And some trouble now in right field. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out.
Hey, guys, that's a well-executed slider down the way right there. The batter just did an amazing job of staying inside the baseball and driving it the other way.
Into the box now, number 13, and there are runners at the corners now. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. Strike two as that's taken on the outside part of the plate. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. And he fouls this one off. This is line to left. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Twin strand of pair. They trail it 4-1. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the DH, Jose Abreu. The 1-1. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2.
I got to count 2-2.
Got him swinging on the split-fingered pitch, and that's out number one. And here's the switch-hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Bases are empty, one man out. Big swing by Grandal, and a ball carrying well to right. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Fourth home run here in the early going as they stretch the lead to 5-1.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
Into the box, Luis Robert. Count all the way full to the White Sox center fielder. Line drive to left. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Dan, how hard is it to massage your way through such a deep lineup? I mean, even the 8-9 hole hitters are solid big league players.
You know, Mark, these days you're not seeing a lot of defensive specialists in the infield or outfield. If you're in that starting lineup these days, there's a pretty good job you can swing the bat.
In there, now the throw. He's well behind the play. That's an easy stolen base. Five runs, seven hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. And it's fouled away. Another 1-2 delivery. And he struck him out, so he's down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
At the plate, Tim Anderson. And now the runner's trying for third. Rolled slowly down the third baseline. Barehanded on the move. Just late. He's safe. That was a phenomenal stop, but it winds up a base hit, and the inning continues.
Hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch and there's an infield knock.
It is, D-Roy, and you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that ball is going to be hit on.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. White Sox able to add on thanks to the solo home run. The 9-1-2 hitters due up to start the seventh. It's now 5-1. Jimmy Cordero is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. All set for the start of the inning, and digging in is the outfielder, Byron Buxton. Ready on 1-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Scooped up, and the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. So the batting order turns over now, and set to go Luis Arraez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Here's the two-seam fastball that bears in a bit too tight. It's ball 4. So now to the plate will be Andrelton Simmons. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. There's one. On to first. It's a double play as their woes continue. The inning is over. Nothing doing here for the Twins. They're down here 5-1. Last half of the seventh here, and next will be the switch hitting third baseman, Yoan Moncada. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Hey, that's a well-executed pitch right there. That might have started middle, but you saw it breaking away to that outer part of the zone. This left-handed batter right here has got two decisions to make. Is he going to ground out to second base all day, or is he going to drive the ball the other way?
And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first out. So now it'll be the 4-hole hitter, Eloy Jimenez. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. So two away here is the Sox bat in the seventh, and that will bring up the power bat of Edwin Encarnacion. Seventh inning here in a 5-1 ball game. Line drive to left. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So that means Jose Abreu will come to the plate here. Jose Abreu will stand in, and as he does, we'll flash you back to the first inning of the ballgame. A 3-run shot had him off and running right out of the gate. The 2-1 home to short, hit hard. Simmons has it, and that will conclude matters here in the seventh. A man left for the White Sox. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Ready to begin the eighth, and striding forward, the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz. The 3-1. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2. The White Sox are maintaining a slim lead in the late going of this series finale, so if they can wrap it up, they'll complete the series sweep.
Hey, Matt, what a great spot to be in. You're playing good baseball, you're going for the sweep, and you're leading by a few runs going into the later innings. Now it's just time to close the deal.
High and deep to right center after it is eaten. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Miguel Sano. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 3-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and that's a full count now, 3 balls and 2 strikes. And even sweeter, of course, is getting that series sweep in your own ballpark in front of the home faithful. So we'll see if they can send these fans home happy.
No doubt about it. Fan base is excited. They're all out in full force, coming to the ballpark hoping to witness a sweep, and it looks pretty good at this point.
Drill down the line.
Man, the batter's eyes lit up right there. A hanger just a little bit out in front. Couldn't keep it fair.
Hit sharply on the ground, and that's through for his first base hit in this one. Cutting it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at-bat right there, probably his last at-bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never, and I'm sure when he walked into that batter's box right there, he's thinking, this very well could be my last AB of this game, so if I'm going to keep this streak alive, going to have to do it right now.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. 5-1 our score as we play the eighth. Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Here now the 2-2. Back up the middle. And there's his first base hit in this one.
Dan, if they're going to crack Drew, this has got to be the opportunity they've been looking for right here. They've had a ton of hits, a ton of people on base, but no one has been able to come up with that big knock.
Well, you know what, Dero? This pitcher's kind of worked around trouble the entire time so far. Another inning brewing right here. Let's see if they can't get a big hit here right here and bust through in this one.
So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. At the plate now, Max Kepler down the first baseline, fielded by Encarnacion on the first, and talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. So fine work there from the White Sox bullpen. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. It's the White Sox 5 and the Twins 1. Cody Stashek is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and digging in is the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. And he takes strike 3 called on the fastball, one gone. Digging in now, Luis Robert. Last time through was a base hit. The 2-1 home. Leury Garcia is on deck. The 3-1 pitch. And he takes ball 4, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by. But on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
Now batting, Leury Garcia. He was hunched out looking at strike 3 last time through.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get
completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Still even at 2-2. Runner at first here, one man out. This is hit softly to third, but gloved by the third baseman for the out. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Runners off for second. High and deep down the left field line. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. He's on the move again from first. Pitch inside. The throw is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
It was pretty obvious he would likely be on the move with two outs, and I'm sure the defense knew it too. But he has lightning speed and was able to take the bag anyways.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Lifted in the air to center field. Buxton is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. White Sox leave one. They're up 5-1. Into the box now, Josh Donaldson. His career numbers against this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Here's the 1-1. Misses badly. It's ball two. Action in the White Sox bullpen now as they have a left-hander getting loose. The 2-2.
Three balls, two strikes.
This is in the air out to straightaway center. Robert has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out. Now at the plate, number 13. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
And he popped him up. Back into foul territory behind first. And no one can get there. It's a foul ball. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location, because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you can do with that. Textbook sinker.
Final strike for the Twins. This is foul right side. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. A punch out to end it as the White Sox break out the brooms at home and sweep their division rivals.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
5-1, the final total in today's game. The Chicago White Sox jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Number 34 takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. Jose Berríos was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. Aaron Bummer hammers down the five-out save, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.